And all that filled in last week, I felt horrible, and I feel wonderful today. So, praise the Lord. Say thank you. Thank you all for your prayers. I appreciate it very much. It's good just to be able to have a voice and to be able to worship God. Amen. So let's just lift our hands toward heaven, invite the presence of the Lord here in this place. God, we love you, and God, we thank you, God, for allowing us this opportunity, Lord, just to be in your presence. God, you said in your word, where two or three would come together in your name, you'd be here. And Father, we thank you for allowing us this opportunity. Help us, Lord, to worship you in spirit and in truth. God, we ask it all in the name of Jesus. And everyone said, amen. Amen. Let's worship him this morning.
Man, good seeing my brother here this morning. I didn't see you come in, but I heard you. So I said, I know who that is. Amen. Amen. Let's worship this morning, church, as we sing this opening song, Oh, I Want to See Him.
As I journey through the land, singing as I go, pointing souls to Calvary, to the crimson flow. Many arrows pierce my soul from without within, but my Lord leads me on, through him I must swim. Oh, I want to see him, look upon his face, there to sing forever of your saving grace. On the streets of glory, let me lift my voice. Here's all past, home at last, never to rejoice. When in service for my Lord, dark may be the night, but I'll cling more close to him, he will give me light. Satan's snares may vex my soul, turn my thoughts aside, but my Lord goes ahead, leads with every tide. Oh, I want to see him, look upon his face, there to sing forever of his saving grace. On the streets of glory, let me lift my voice. Here's all past, home at last, never to rejoice. When in valleys low, Savior there, leading in the fight, with the tender hand outstretched toward the valley low. Oh, guiding me, I can see as I onward go. Oh, I want to see him, look upon his face, there to see forever of his saving grace. On the streets of glory, let me lift my voice. There's all when before me billows rise from the mighty deep, then my Lord directs my bark, he does safely keep, and he leads me gently on through this world below. He's a real friend to me, oh, I love him so. Oh, I want to see him, look upon his face, there to sing forever of his saving grace. On the streets of glory, let me lift my voice. There's all past, hope at last, ever to rejoice. And oh, I want to see him, look upon his face, there to sing forever of his saving grace. On the streets of glory, let me lift my voice. There's all past, hope at last, ever to rejoice. Oh, there's all past, hope at last, ever to rejoice.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sore, still we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. It's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion till salvation comes. These are the days of Ezekiel, the dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding the temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, the fields are as wide as the world. And we are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, he comes, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice, hear up to believe,
oh, yeah.
And out of Zion till salvation comes. Behold, clouds shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. It's the year of Jubilee, and round of Zion till salvation comes. There's no God like Jehovah. 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 Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. It's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion till salvation comes. Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. It's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's house salvation comes. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah. There's no God like Jehovah.
Sing it, church.
There's no God like Jehovah. 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 Behold, he comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. It's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's hill salvation comes. So lift your voice, it's the year of Jubilee, and out of Zion's hill salvation comes.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
You're worthy, God.
Thank you.
No God like Jehovah.
You, oh,
worship you, and I call you Waymaker,
Miracle Worker.
That is who you are. You're my way maker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. Oh, listen to this. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop working. You never stop,
oh, yes.
You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. Oh, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Oh, you're my waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. That is who you are.
That is who you are.
That is who you are.
That is who you are.
Oh, that is who you are.
That is who you are.
That is who you are.
That is who you are. When they say, who is your God? I say, he's my way maker. He's my miracle worker. That is who he is. We might not see it. We might not feel it. But he is still moving. I don't know about you, but I feel a presence here this morning. I feel God saying, I'm moving. I'm moving in your midst. And all you gotta do is just receive it. I'm gonna give it. I'm gonna pour it out. Oh, dear Heavenly Father, can we do that? Do that verse 2 again.
You are here. You're touching every heart. I worship you.
Worshiping this morning.
Oh, I worship you. You are here, you're healing every life. I worship you, oh, I worship you. That's why I call you Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. Promise
darkness.
Oh, yes, God, that's who you are.
The darkness,
that is who you are.
My God, that is who you are. That is who you are.
That's who you are.
Stop working.
Never,
you never stop. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop. You never stop working. You never stop. You never stop working. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper. Keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
Waymaker. You know, there's times in our lives when we look and we don't know if we can find a way. We don't see a way through this trouble. But God is a way maker. It goes on to say miracle worker. Miracle means when everything seems lost, when you can't explain it. He is a miracle worker. He's promised you He'd always be with you. He is still a promise keeper. We're living in a dark world, but He is our light. He is our light. Praise God. You are so good. You are so good. Oh, dear God. Thank you, Jesus, for your presence. Thank you for your presence, God. Thank you, Jesus, for sweeping across here. Yes, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Have I not said, will I not make a way where there seems to be no way? Have I not said, I am the Lord thy God, and I'm alive forevermore? I say unto you this day, my people, cast your cares upon me, because I care for you, saith the Lord. I say unto you this day, my people, I am the Lord thy God, and there is nothing too hard for me. There is nothing that I cannot do, saith the Lord. But surely, if you will cast your care upon me, I will do the things you think cannot happen. For I am the Lord thy God, and I am able to do exceedingly abundantly, more than you can even imagine and think. I say unto you this day, my people, trust me and know that I am God.
I tell you, church, I'm sick and tired of the devil always trying to get in my ear and tell me when things are going bad that it's never going to work out. I'm tired of him taking my family. I'm tired of him trying to mess with me and thinking I'm not a threat. I don't know about you, but I'm tired of it. I'm tired of the enemy trying to attack my brothers and sisters in this church. Time and time again, I've heard it be said, Seek me. Seek me. Doesn't mean just say, oh, thank you, Jesus, once in a while. It means you come after him with everything that you can. It means that you got to put certain things to the side because we got to make time. As Sister Poole said this morning, we have to. We have to put it inside of us where people can see it. Let me tell you something. If you go walking out at work or wherever you are and people don't see that you're a Christian, if they have to ask if you're a Christian, then obviously we are not showing enough of God in us. God is looking for a church that's seeking Him. Seeking Him. Seeking Him. Seeking Him. With a raise in your hand, you're saying, brother, I'm going to seek Him with everything I have. I'm going to seek Him. And I'm going to leave all my problems right there. He just said, I just said it right there. You give them to me. You give me your problems. Quit worrying about it. Quit stressing out about it. I will make a way. There is no problem too big for Him. He will make a way when there seems to be no way. So don't think, oh, wait a minute, this is too big, because there's nothing too big. Pray with me right now that God's going to just move in a mighty way. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning, God. We're looking to you. We're going to believe, God, you're going to reach out and you're going to touch each and every one, God. You're going to move in miraculous ways, just as your word has just said, God, that if we seek you, if we put up our troubles upon you, God, that you will take care of them, God, that you will make way when there seems to be no way. We believe it, and that's your promise, so we're just going to take it right now and claim it, God. Victory in your name, in Jesus' name, amen.
And you've done all you could do, and you prayed all you could pray, yet you still could not get through. He speaks to you in love, saying that he understands. Now that you've done all that you can, just stand. Oh, just stand. Salvation of the Lord. He's a strong and mighty tower, a calm wind in a storm. If you're trembling in fear, remember that He's near. Oh, He's always got a plan. Just stand.
Sing that chorus again. Just
salvation of the Lord. He's a strong and mighty tower, a calm within a storm. If you're trembling in fear, remember that He's near. Oh, He's always got a plan. Just stand. So if you're trembling, remember that He's near. He's always got a plan. Just stand.
Somebody needs to know, you just need to stand still this morning. Quit worrying about it. Quit fretting about it. And just let God work it out. So many times we try to work things out and do things that God needs to do. We cannot do it. We are limited. But God is an unlimited God that can do, amen, more than we can even imagine and think. I want to sing this again this morning. Somebody just needs to just stand there. listen to the words of this song and know that God is going to work on your behalf today. If you'll just let go and give it to Him, He'll take it and He'll work it out. Amen. Let's sing it again this morning.
Now if the fight's been hard and long, with no victory in sight, it seems all hope is gone, and you have no strength to fight. In the weakness of your faith, you just know God has a plan. Oh, you're safe within His hands, just stand. Salvation of the Lord. He's a strong and mighty tower, a calm within a storm. If you're trembling in fear, remember that He's near. He's always got a plan, just stand. And if you're trembling in fear, remember that He's near. He's always got a plan, just stand.
Do you believe that this morning? Give Him a hand clap of praise. Come on. Aren't you thankful today? God has always got a plan. Hallelujah. You may be seated this morning if you can be. Dismiss our kids back to kids' church. I think they're already going. Appreciate the presence of the Lord. Amen. Surely the Lord is in this place today. And I don't want to get in His way. Amen. I just want Him to have His way. This is His place. His time. Amen. If you have your Bibles this morning, I'd like you to turn to 1 Peter chapter 2, and we're going to read verse number 9. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse number 9. If you would like to stand for the reading of the Word, feel free. If you're not able, that's fine. Don't feel obligated. It says, "But you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of Him who hath called you out of darkness into," amen, "His marvelous light." How many knows this morning this is a marvelous light? Hallelujah. This is a marvelous light. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Father, I thank You, Lord, for Your presence. God, I thank You for the Holy Ghost that's in this house. Father, anoint me and use me. Help me, God, to say what You once said here this morning. God, help me not to say what I want to say, but God, help me to say what the Holy Ghost would have me to say. God, help me to decrease, Lord, that You might increase. God, anoint our ears and our hearts, and God, let us receive Your word with gladness. And Father, I pray it all in the name of Jesus. And everyone said, amen. Amen. You may be seated. Our theme for 23 is living free. And I believe this morning if we're going to live free in 2023, amen, we need to know who we are. Amen. You need to know who you are this morning. Amen. The Word of God says you are a chosen generation. Amen. You need to understand this morning you are not an accident. You are not a mistake. But you are chosen by the Lord God Almighty. You are a chosen generation. God knew who would be here today, and He wants each and every one of you to know that He has chosen you. You are chosen by Almighty God. Your family may reject you. People may, amen, push you to the side, but God has chosen you. You are a chosen generation. And if we're going to live free in 2023, we need to know who we are. Amen. We're not at the bottom of the barrel. We're chosen by Almighty God. The world may say we're outcast, or they may say, amen, just be quiet and hush. Amen, but the Word of God says that we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and we are to show forth His praises. Amen. We are royalty today. Not just are you chosen, but you are a royal generation. Amen. You have value. Know in your heart, I have value. You want to live free in 2003? Know who you are. I am a child of the Most High God. I have been blood bought. I have been redeemed. And I have been adopted into a royal family. I got royal blood flowing through my veins. You, if you've accepted Christ into your hearts, you got royal blood flowing in your veins. Amen? We are a royal priesthood. Amen? We're a part of the family, amen, of the kingdom of God. Amen. God's kingdom is higher, amen, stronger and greater than any other kingdom ever established. And you and I are a part of His kingdom. Amen. Aren't you thankful for that this morning? Amen. People may say, I'm not worth anything, or people may try to tell you you're not worth anything. Amen. You need to know who you are. You are valuable to God today. And you have a right to praise God. Amen. He said to show forth the praises of Him. Who is Him? Jesus is the one that has called us out of the darkness into the marvelous light. And we are to show forth His praises. Not just with our words, but with our lives, by the way that we live. See, you can say, I'm a Jesus follower, you can wear a cross around your neck and you can get the biggest t-shirt in the world that says Jesus saves. But how many knows if your life doesn't portray what your lips say, what your shirt says, how many knows you're not showing forth praise unto God? We're to show forth our praises unto God. Amen. Why? Because He has brought us out of the darkness into the light. He's given us a new heart, a new life. And He is worthy of our praise this morning. Not just in our lip service, but in our lives. Amen. We have a right to praise Him. Don't let the devil tell you you're not worthy to praise God. Amen. You are made worthy through the blood of Jesus. Bible says there's none righteous, no, not one. We were all unrighteous, but through the righteousness of Christ, we are made righteous and we are able to give praise unto God. Amen. And we should no longer be walking in darkness. If you want to live free in 23, get out of the darkness. Get out of the darkness. Quit being ashamed of who you are. Don't be afraid to identify with Christ. Amen. Get out of the darkness and get over in the marvelous light. Hallelujah. Amen. Aren't you glad He brought you out of darkness into the light? And why do we keep running back to the darkness? Too many of God's people trying to hide in the darkness, and then Sunday comes and we want to come out and look in the light, look at me. Monday comes, we want to run back into the darkness. Amen. I have no desire to go back into the darkness. God has brought me out of the darkness into this marvelous light. I found Jesus is a better way. Yes. Living in the light is a better way. Amen. Yes. No longer are we in darkness, but we've been brought into the marvelous light. Amen. How many knows this morning we are overcomers? Revelations 12, verse 11. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. And they loved not their lives unto death. Amen. We need to know this morning, we are overcomers by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. What is your testimony? That Jesus Christ is the Son of God. That Jesus Christ, amen, has forgiven me of my sin. Jesus Christ is Lord and ruler of my heart and my life. Amen. Let us testify and not be ashamed that Jesus Christ is still King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And He is still holy and He is still to be reverenced today. Amen. Hallelujah. We are overcomers by the blood of the Lamb. When the devil tells you you can't make it, you tell him, I'm an overcomer by the blood of Jesus Christ. I will make it. Amen. Know who you are in Christ. Know who you are this morning and live free in 2023 knowing that I'm an overcomer. Yeah, I will be opposed and I will have obstacles that come in my life in 2023. I'm not preaching to you some glamorous gospel where you come to Jesus and everything's going to be perfect and rosy. You will be opposed, but you can also overcome the opposition. I wish I could get it out like I feel it this morning. Amen. We are overcomers. You are not defeated. You will be victorious. As long as you hold on to your testimony of knowing Christ as your Lord and Savior. Amen. We are overcomers by the blood of Jesus Christ today. His blood will still help you overcome in 2023. And how many knows today we are conquerors? Romans tells us we're more than conquerors. Romans 8:37. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors. Amen. Because I joined a church, because I'm Pentecostal, because I wrote my name down in a denomination book. No. Why? What does it say? Huh? We are more than conquerors through Him who loved us through Christ. We are more than conquerors today. Amen. Get your head up today. We are not defeated. We are more than conquerors today. You may feel cast down. Amen. But thank God you may get cast down. But thank God you won't be destroyed. That's right. He's defeated today. Amen. Don't let the devil tell you you can't live for God. You tell the devil, I will live for God and I will succeed. Yes, yes, yes. Too many people are trying to ride a roller coaster to heaven. Up, down, in and out. Come to church if you feel good. Come to church if everything's going good. How many knows living for God is a good way? It should be a steady way. Amen. We are more than conquerors. We have everything we need in us. Christ in us is the hope of glory. Amen. If you want to live free in 2003, know today you are more than a conqueror through Christ. But so many times we fail and we falter because we try to do things in ourselves that God desires to do. We are more than conquerors through Christ. Amen. It's through Christ that gives us the strength to conquer the obstacles, the pitfalls, and the things the devil throws in our path. But when we try to live without Christ, we will fall. Through Christ, we are more than conquerors. Amen? In all things that the enemy puts in our path. Amen? There will be things put in your path in 2023 that you may not see coming. We sang that song, God's Always Got a Plan. Huh? I may not know how, I may not know when, I didn't see it coming, but I know that if I'm in Christ Jesus, I am more than a conqueror. I will not be defeated. Amen? And we need to know this morning, we are loved by God. You are loved by God. John 16, verse 27 says, For the Father Himself loveth you, because you have loved Me. Talking about loving Jesus. If you have loved Jesus, the Father loves you, and hath believed that I am came out from God. We need to understand today, you are loved by God. So many people think God is out to get them and get them and send them to hell, but God is not out to get anybody except for get you to heaven and let you know that He loves you today. If you're going to live free in 2023, you need to know my Heavenly Father loves me. God loves me. Not just when I do good. Not just when I can jump through hoops and say, look at me. I'm doing good this week. How many know God loves us in spite of our faults, in spite of our shortcomings, in spite of our failures? Amen. God's love is consistent. His love never changes. And we don't have to come to a plateau and get to a place where we can say, well, now God loves me. At the lowest place in your life, as low as you can get, God loves you. Amen. God loves us exactly right where we're at. And His love for us never changes. You need to know today, God loves you. When you brush your teeth in the morning, you tell yourself, God loves me. Huh? Know who you are. Amen. God loves me. I don't deserve God to love me. I told you before, I shook my fist at God and said, leave me alone. I want nothing to do with you, but thank God He didn't. Thank God He still kept loving me. Amen. When I tried to run from Him, when I tried to hide from Him, He kept on loving me. And He'll keep on loving each and every one of you today. So you need to know in your heart, God loves me. And you don't have to prove yourself to God. God loves you. God knows you. He knows exactly your thoughts. He knows how many hairs you have on your head. He knows when you get up. He knows when you go down. He knows what you look at, what you listen to. But He chooses to continue to love you. Let that sink in your head today. Let it get out of your head, down in your heart. How about that? Amen. God loves me. God loves you. You want to live free in 2003? Understand that my Creator of the universe loves me. Amen? I'm loved by God. And I am not who I used to be. 2 Corinthians 5, verse 17 says, Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Amen. Aren't you glad this morning you're a new creature in Christ? I don't need a bottle to feel fulfilled this morning. I don't need a joint to feel fulfilled this morning. I don't need money to find fulfillment today. I am a new creature in Christ. All things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. I may not be perfect, but I'm working on the new man. We got to let the old things pass away. Too many people want to hold on to the old and try to be the new. We got to let the old things pass away. You want to live free for God? Let the old things go. Put on the new man. Huh? Put on the new man. Sister Poole's talking about do's and don'ts and things this morning. It's not about do's and don'ts. It's about living for God. To please God. Amen. Not because someone said I can't. It's because I don't want to. Amen. It's not because I can't go here anymore. It's because I don't want to go there no more. Amen. Because I am a new creature in Christ. And I am trying to please God by the way I live, by the way I talk, and the places I go to. Amen. You want to live free in 2023, let the old man pass away and put on the new man in Christ. Don't put on the new man according to the church. You put the new man according to Christ. He's the one we're to pattern ourselves after. Amen. I'm not who I used to be. I'm glad I'm not, aren't you? I'm free this morning. I'm free. I was bound by the old man, but I'm free from that old man this morning. Amen. The chains that used to bind me no longer bind me. I am a new creature in Christ Jesus, and I want to run free in 2023. I don't want those hands to be bound anymore. I want to walk free, amen, and be a new creature in Christ. Amen. And remember this morning, we can do all things through Christ that gives us the strength. Philippians 4, verse 13, you know it. I can do all things through Christ which strengthened me. If you're going to live free in 2023, you need to know I can do all things through Christ. There will be things that come in your way in 2023. There will be pitfalls. There will be things that happen in your life that may seem like I cannot do this. But how many knows you're not meant to do it alone? You can do all things through Christ that will give you the strength to go through what you have to go through in 2023. But we cannot lose the mindset that I can do all things through Christ that gives me the strength. He don't expect you to walk through your life in 2023 by yourself. He don't expect you to go through the trials and tests that you're going to have to go through in 2023 all by yourself. He will be there to give you the strength you need to get through what you got to go through. Hallelujah. But we must remember, I can do all things. When I feel like I can't even get up and go to church, I'm going to get up anyway. Because God is going to give me the strength. God is going to give me the strength. When I feel like I can't pray, I'm going to pray anyway. When I feel like I can't do anymore, I'm going to do it anyway. Because Christ is going to give me the strength. Amen. Talking about living free in 2023, we need to remember I can do all things through Christ. Amen. And we must remember there will be times that we have to resist the devil in 2023. Amen? Amen. James 4, verse 7 says, submit yourself therefore to God. Resist the devil. And sometimes if he has... No. It says, and he will flee from you. There will be times in 2023 where you're going to have to get mad at the devil and you're going to have to stand up and tell him in the name of Jesus, leave me alone. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Come on. Leave me alone. I have submitted to God. Leave me alone, devil. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Sister Poole taught us when we were young Christians, use the Word of God. Use the Word of God. The Word of God says, if I submit to God, the devil's got to flee from me. So many times we want to resist the devil, but we don't want to submit. Huh? Go, devil. In the name of the Pentecostal Church of God, go. How many know? Pastor Chris said, you got to leave me alone. No. The Word of God says, if I submit to God, you got to leave me alone. How many knows you may not have to say it more? You may have to say it more than one time. Sometimes you got to get angry. Sometimes you got to... Anyway. We got to get sick and tired of the devil. Amen. He knows time is short. He's working overtime. He's doing his job. Look at the news. Look in the newspaper. Look at your families. He's doing his job. What about us? Are we pleading the blood over our families? Are we going into our prayer closet and declaring war against the enemy? Get your hands off my children. Get your hands off my grandkids. I submit to God and I give them over to you. Hallelujah. Come on, give him praise. Hallelujah. We are children of the Most High God. You need to know who you are this morning. Our God is not dead. He's not asleep. He's not on the cross. But he's at the right hand of the Father making intercession for you and I today. You're a royal generation. I mean a royal priesthood. Sorry. Oh. Anyway, let's go on. How many knows this morning our body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? 1 Corinthians 6, verse 19 and 20. What know you not? Your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost which is in you, which you have of God, and you are not your own. Do you get that? We are not our own. Know who you are. Remember? Knowing who we are. If we're going to live free, we got to know who we are. I'm not my own. Get your agenda out of the way. Throw your plans to the side. Get your ideas out the window. I'm not my own. It says, for you are bought with a price. What kind of price were we bought with? The royal, precious, precious, precious blood of Jesus. That's what we've been purchased with. And we need to understand our bodies are the temple of the Spirit of God. How many knows God's not going to dwell in an unclean temple? If we're putting stuff in our bodies that we shouldn't be putting in our bodies, how many knows we're not living free? God wants us to live free in 2023, but we will not live free if we're putting junk inside our bodies that are harming us, that are hurting us, that are not good for us. We need to know who we are. We are the temple of the Holy Ghost. The Spirit of Almighty God lives in you. And you're to take care of this temple. Amen? Know who you are. I am the temple. A filthy, no good, rotten, filthy sinner is now the temple of the Spirit of God. That's who we are. We're not little gods. But the Spirit of God lives in us. And we can live free in 2023. Why? Because He abides in me. Let the Word of God abide in you richly. We talked about it in Sunday school this morning. You got to let the Word of God be alive and rich in your body and your life. Amen. How many knows this morning, Matthew 16, verse 18, the gates of hell are not going to prevail against us. I say unto you also, unto thee, thou art Peter, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. If you've accepted Christ into your heart and life, if you've accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior of your heart, you're building upon the rock. You have the rock in you. How many knows this morning, if we will build our lives upon the rock, the Bible says the gates of hell shall not prevail against us. We may get knocked down. We may get cast down. We may fall down. But thank God, if we stay on the rock, we will not be defeated. Just because you fall doesn't mean that you're a failure. You can get back up. So know who you are. I'm building upon Jesus Christ and Him crucified. I'm building my life upon the rock. And the gates of hell will not prevail against me. Amen. Amen. I'm hurrying. In closing today as they return to the music. We need to remember God is for us. God is for us. Let's stand today. Talking about living free, knowing who we are. We need to know God is for me, not against me. God is not against you. The gates of hell are against you, but they will not prevail. They will not prevail. Why? Because He is for you. Amen. Romans 8, verse 31. What shall we say then to these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? Amen. We will have people come against us in our lives. In 2023, people are going to oppose you. They're going to come against you. They're going to try to run your name through the mud. They're going to try to do everything they can to discourage you. But you need to remember, it doesn't matter how many people is against you, as long as God is for you. Know who you are. I'm a child of God. And God is for me today, not against me. John 14, verse 2 says, in my house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. You have a place waiting on you in heaven. Amen. Jesus said, if I go, I'll go to prepare a place for you. We need to know I got a place waiting on me in glory. I may get opposed in 2023. I may have to go through some stuff in 2023 that I may not enjoy, but I got a place waiting on me in glory. As we bow our heads and close our eyes today, maybe you're here this morning. Maybe you feel like you're not free. Maybe you feel like there's stuff in your life that's keeping you from being free. Maybe condemnation. Maybe people. Maybe things. Whatever it might be, the altar's open. And the Lord says to you today, if you'll come, He'll free you from whatever holds you. But you got to make a step of faith today and say, I want to live free in 2023. I want to know who I am in Christ Jesus. If that's you today, come join us at the altar. It don't mean you're a sinner. It means I want to be free from anything that would keep me. Anybody else, come, join us. Can I have some help? Come pray. Somebody over here. Or maybe you're here today, you don't feel worthy. Maybe you've messed up. Maybe you've made mistakes. God's here to forgive you. The Bible says if we confess our sin, He's faithful and just to forgive us. We don't have to confess it to one another. We just need to confess it to God. God's here to forgive. If anybody else, the altars are open. If you don't want to come to the front, let's all find a place of prayer. Can we spend some time talking to our Father? Hallelujah.
But He brought me in, oh, His love for me. Oh, His love for me. Through the sunset tree, oh, is free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am.
Free at last, He has ransomed me. His grace runs deep.
Yeah.
While I was a slave to sin, Jesus died for me.
Yes, He died for me. Through the sun sets free. Oh, is free indeed. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am. In my Father's house, there's a place for me. I'm a child of God. Yes, I am.
Through the sun sets free.
Of praise this morning. Come on, are you thankful today? Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
I am redeemed.
Yes.
Bought with a price. Jesus has changed my whole life. If anybody asks you just who I am, tell them I am redeemed. Oh, I am redeemed. I'm bought with a price. Jesus has changed my whole life. If anybody asks you just who I am, tell them I am redeemed. If anybody asks you just who I am, tell them, I am redeemed.
Hallelujah. Come on, give him another hand clap of praise.
Yes.
Hallelujah. 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 And because we are redeemed, we can live free in 2023. Amen? Do you believe that this morning? We're not redeemed by corruptible things, but by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. I hope this morning the Word of God has challenged you, reminded you, remember who you are in Christ. Amen. Remember service tonight. Sister Jennifer is going to be ministering. Come back expecting. Amen. God's not done yet. Amen. Those of you that are leaders, please be here promptly at 5 o'clock this afternoon. Amen. Let's bow our heads to be dismissed. Amen. Brother Tom Melvin, will you dismiss us today?
Thank you.